Dame un tenedor.
Sí.
A ver, ahí pues meterle el tajo. Y meterlo encima de la otra.
Así.
Ahí.
Welcome to my art and life vlog number 11. If you are new here, I will briefly introduce myself. My name is Christina. I come from Germany, but I live in Buenos Aires with my family since 2008. And I'm a mixed media artist and I'm super passionate about art journaling and, yeah, all things creative. And in this blog I share about my art, about my processes, about my personal life, and yeah, everything that comes up over the course of me filming a vlog, which can be a month or a bit longer. So yeah, welcome, and I hope you enjoy my new vlog. I wanted to film an introduction to this new vlog before I pack my studio corner in this room. If you have seen the vlog that I put out last, the vlog number 10, you already know that we are in winter and next week starts winter break for my kids and my husband too. He works in a school also. And we want to switch rooms in our house. So now the kids have a room together, but they are now old enough that it is high time for them to have their separate rooms. And this means we will be switching around all the rooms upstairs. And yeah, the other day my husband came and said, yeah, you should maybe start to pack your things together and take down all the decorations because, yeah, next week we will start renovations. And I said, yeah, that's true. But then I remembered, okay, if I want to film an introduction, I should maybe do that before I pack everything together, because it may be a few weeks until I have a space where I can sit down and make art and film videos. So yeah, I will show you how the renovations are going, but maybe I won't have a place to talk to you. I already wanted to film this introduction yesterday, but it was raining and we have a tin roof, so it was very noisy, even if it is not a really heavy rain. Because of the roof, it gets noisy pretty fast. I also was editing a video and had to stop that because I could not hear which background noises there were with the rain coming down. So yeah, we are lately having lots of rain, which is good because Argentina suffered from a severe drought over the last couple of years. I don't know, at least one, maybe 2 years, and it affected greatly the agribusiness. And Argentina is a country that depends to a certain level on their exports of grains, soybeans, and other products that are made from the soybeans, and other agricultural products like apples, pears, lemons, and other things. So that affected The drought affected greatly the agribusiness and the export products. And the economy. We are living in a pretty heavy, severe economic crisis that is getting heavier to deal with over the last few years. I don't want to bore you with the details because the situation is very complex, but maybe I should not even talk about that, but it's something that affects us all. The drought was severe, the economic crisis is severe, and in order to get better, a lot of rain and the water reservoirs in the ground filling up again, and the rivers and the lakes and everything is like a great thing. So hopefully it will get a bit better with the next harvest season. But yeah, the situation is far more complicated than that. We have huge inflation, and so that does affect us. It's like we live with that, and you kind of get used to it. And I have to say, my family, we are very, very lucky. My husband and I, we both have stable jobs and stable income that gets raised every month. As of now, with the inflation, so we are kind of getting by good enough. Yeah, if you have more questions, I can talk more about that, but I seriously, don't want to go into politics too much, into the economic situation too much, but on the other hand, it's also something that, that is a reality that we live in. As for the art, let's talk about art. Let's talk about creativity. I am super inspired right now. I'm doing another art challenge. I have been talking about Messy May in my latest vlog a lot. We are now in July, and I'm participating in Junk Journal July, which is another challenge with daily prompts. And it's a bit more slow going than the Messy May, but I also have a tutorial to edit. I am preparing some cyanotypes. I'm working on another portrait. And I mentioned that briefly, I think, in my latest vlog, I'm doing like a lot of little collage elements that I can use later. Something I thought I had never done before, that's not quite true. I think I did make here and there some little stuff, a bit of collage fodder, but it wasn't something I was doing often. And I also thought, okay, now I'm doing these things. Why am I doing these things? Will I use them in my journals? And I do find that now that I have them, I do use them also. So that is great. And I have kind of a little box of treasures where I collect all the things. And thanks for watching my very random talk so far. I will show you my collage elements, and then I will slowly start to pack up all the stuff that you see around here and prepare for switching rooms. And I don't know when I will be able to talk to you in a quiet moment again. I wish you a great time. Let's see what comes up over the next few weeks that I can show you.
Okay, here we are facing down on my desk. Before we come to the collage elements, I wanted to show you my junk journal July journal, which I think is great. It's bigger than the Messy May one, so yeah, the pages take a bit longer to make. And I put the prompts here and the artists that are participating in the collaboration. And I already have some pages, some that I really love and a lot of space, and some that are okay. So yeah, I will film a video of that once I'm finished for sure. But yeah, maybe you appreciate the look. So that let's come to the collage elements that I'm really excited about. And here we are. So I have been making and very much enjoying these collage clusters with some words and elements. These are just paper scraps glued together and with some words on them. Some stickers, flowers, more stickers. And these are just really fast. You grab some glue and some paper scraps and make little clusters, and then you can embellish them with some watercolor, candy wrapper, stickers, words, whatever you want to. I even got my sewing machine out and did some stitching here and there and some of them. So yeah, I learned something about glue also, because I was using a gel medium, and as I did more collage than before, I went to the jar pretty quickly. And then I went to a art supply store here nearby, and I bought a multi-purpose glue, and I started to make a few of these, and the glue was so sticky and it didn't dry. I used it just like the gel medium, like putting it on the scraps, over the scraps, and yeah, that did not work. I had like paper and glue stuck everywhere, and it was just really awful. So I went back and I asked the lady, and she said, oh yeah, no, that this glue is not for putting over the scraps, it's just for if you want to make collage, you put it on your page and you put your collage down, and not something too thin, so no tissue paper, because the glue is very strong. So yeah, and then I bought a Mod Podge that works okay, but it's more shiny, it's shinier than the gel medium. So yeah, it's okay for now, but the next time I go to another bit bigger art supply store, I will go for a gel medium again and use that for these kind of collage things. So then I have a little bag with letters. These are letters or random words, and I use them for my quotes that I often do with individual letters. So then I have a bag with finger painted flowers and strawberries. These were super fun to make. I learned how to make the flowers in one of the Messy May tutorials, or yeah, prompt interpretations from some artists. And then I thought, what else apart from flowers can I make? And I came up with strawberries. So I have a bunch of strawberries. And the other thing I came up with were butterflies. So I also finger painted and then embellished a whole stack of butterflies, like these and these.
So this was super fun. And I think Sunday morning practice while my family was still asleep. So yeah, I painted these butterflies and then embellished and cut them out over the day. I also have some bigger flowers, also finger painted. So some roses, some cornflowers, and some more, maybe more generic flowers. I love this one. I really like this one. So then we have these little mini collages. This is a mini series inspired by a tutorial from Andrea Gunkler in one of the Creasphere tutorials from last year. So I made this collage paper on a brown, these flowers on a brown paper and this one, and then I created some mini collages. And I just put them here because I thought, yeah, maybe I can include them in some way in a journal page, or then maybe I was thinking about greeting cards or something, but here I have a place to leave them and have them at hand. These are also from a tutorial in Creasphere in the taster sessions. These were supposed to be little portraits on tags. I don't have tags. These manila tags, so I cut up an old painting that my son made, I think, and I put collage on and I made some little portraits. Then I saw these paper weaving things. I saw this on the YouTube channel of Lisa Goddard, and she makes some awesome things with paper weaving and sewing and then mixed media art. She even makes journals out of these. So I wanted to try that and found that very, very entertaining, like for just doing something. And yeah, I made a little stack of these. And I really love them, and I already included one in one of my pages. So yeah, now that I have these things, I do include them, I find. So that's great. These are collage cards that I made from another tutorial. And the thing is that you don't have only collage on one side, but you have it on two sides. And so one of the fold-outs in my junk journal is made from one of these. And with all of these things, it's so much faster, easier, and less, it takes the pressure away to make several. So that's why I have a lot of all of these. Yeah, several of every one to later include in my journals. And then I have these faces that I painted recently in the Make Create Express taster sessions. These were intuitive faces on different, yeah, collage papers. So I have book pages and other things. And these are just Stabilo oil pencil drawings and a bit of acrylic ink and paint and some scribbles, and yeah, just some of these also to include in my journals. And I really like most of them, not all of them, but yeah, I guess they will find homes on my pages. Yeah, this is the one that I don't like. I kept it anyway because I thought maybe I just use half of it, or I rip it up and use it in a collage or something. We'll see. So yeah, that is all that I have in my treasure box so far. Lots of nice things to use in my journals or make cards from or other little art pieces.
Mancha's helping me with the cyanotypes. Yeah. We have amazing winter sun today. So I will do a little series of cyanotypes. And here you can see my assistant. So I made these little Polaroid shaped papers. And I have these six and six more. Let's see, and I was thinking about calling them sidewalk treasures because they are all things that I found in my backyard and on the sidewalk. There, I thought I would give you a little update on our renovation project that is in full swing by now. And I also realized that I never did a tour of my house, but so yeah, okay, let's start for the rooms that we already worked in. So we started in this space where before we had on this side where the sofa now is, we had a super big wardrobe occupying all the space, but it was always half empty, and from the things that were in it we used only half of them. So we sorted things out and through and gave stuff away and threw the whole thing out, and then we started to paint the walls so they are now nice and clean, and we moved some furniture in. The sofa will probably go to the other side where this wardrobe now is, but this will be gone once we are done. Then we have my husband's desk, or this will be his space. He wants to have a little space for his instruments and maybe record some music and stuff. So there are the guitars. Then we disoccupied what will be our son's room and painted it yesterday. So this was drying overnight, and now the kids will move here to be in this room while we paint the other spaces. So I feel this project is a bit like playing Tetris, where you have to move everything around to create space. So we move always everything around, and this is our current bedroom where we have now all the stuff piled up that has nowhere to go. These are these boxes and these things, and also the suitcase are full of my art stuff. So yeah, my art these days is painting walls and nothing on paper or in journals. So yeah, this is the space we are working in, and our kids' current bedroom will then be our bedroom, and I will get my desk and art space. Here are the stairs, bathroom, and this is the kids'
current bedroom. Oh, it's a bit of a mess. I should have, tended to the beds first. So yeah, it's all a bit messy, but it's working fine so far.
Hello, I'm back again. As you can see, we have done all our house renovations and switched rooms with the kids and all of that. And this will be my new art corner. It's ready to decorate. Let's see what else we can fill the space with. Okay, mostly I have at least the most important stuff in my new corner. I hope you enjoyed this little unpacking video and see you soon.
Okay, so it's getting real. I am in my new space. I have decorated a bit more yesterday and I will give you a little tour and then start working. As I said, my art corner and work corner is in our bedroom now. And there are still a few things that will change. For example, we definitely need a new wardrobe because this one is too small and my husband's clothes do not enter all in this chest of drawers. And this is the one that I'm still missing for my art supplies. This is where our dog sleeps, and here are art supplies. I have two shelves with stuff above my desk. I got this bookcase where I have my journals. One is for journals that I'm still working in, one is for finished journals, and there I have some books and some old books that I will eventually make into journals. And then I have my desk, my breakfast, and I have two drawers. One is art supplies and one is more work stuff. And I have colors there in this box, my acrylic colors, and under the desk for the moment. It's a bit occupied. I have all my magazines in one of these boxes and other collage stuff in the other box. These will move into the chest of drawers once I can have it back. My sewing machine. So, and here we have some bits and bobs that I don't need often. Microphone, stamps, and some other stuff. So yeah, that's it. And I will start my workday and hopefully later also have a bit of time for some art again because I missed it. See you later.
Hello again, good morning. I'm a bit winded. I just did my yoga practice that I finally took back up. I'm really happy about that, but I missed it, and I have to keep getting back into things. I think I'm ready to close out this vlog. I think I have enough stuff to tell you, and it has been a crazy month, July, and we're at the beginning of August now. But before I go, I want to show you some things that I got recently, and I also want to make some art before I start my work day today from home. Yeah, some things are changing. We have a new general manager, and he said, okay, minimum in the office is 2 days, and well, obviously we can go more days. For me, that's quite the change, because I have to organize I have to organize again a bit more with my mother-in-law, so she comes in and takes care of the kids while I'm in the city working. But it's also nice to see my colleagues more, and to have a bit more movement in my days. Overall, I wish you a very nice day, a very nice week, and I hope you are fine. And as always, I want to encourage you, if you like my video or my content, to give it a thumbs up, write me some comments. What do you think about it? If you have any questions, if you like my content, subscribe to my channel. That really helps me yeah, get my viewers or get a bit more exposure, and overall keeps the channel growing bit by bit. I'm really grateful that you are here, that you're watching, and I'm sending you all the best wishes and lots of love as always. Bye.
Okay, so here are the things that I've got. I did not all buy it, and I was the lucky winner of this beautiful set of White Nights watercolors. I have never tried them, and they are pretty cool because they are full pens, so they will last me a long, long time. And I also really love the colors, because I have like a cold and a warm yellow, or well, Indian gold is pretty much a bit more going into orange, but something of that sort. I have a cold and a warm red, I have a cold and a warm blue, I have two different greens, and I have a painted gray, which I really, really love. So yeah, I cannot wait to try these out. I will soon do some swatches. What I was missing in this set and really like and have really few is a purple, so I bought an extra full pen of purple. Then I got myself a set of different palette knives, because I really loved the painting that I did recently only with palette knives of a sunflower in a vase, and I really want to experiment more with that, but I have only one palette knife, and yeah, it's a bit challenging to do like big surfaces with a palette knife of this sort. It's the one that I have, and it's also challenging to do some little details with also this kind of palette knife. So I got myself a little set of these. Then I got a red Posca pen. Then I got myself some neon acrylics. I just want to try those out and want to put some really bold color flecks on some of my pages. Color, yeah, I don't know, color splatters or something on my pages. So I bought these. These are the ones that you get, that you can get for kids. So they are pretty cheap. And I thought, I don't know if I really will use it a lot, so I went for these to start, and if it turns out that I use them a lot, then I may yeah, upgrade. And then I bought a little tripod to, yeah, see if I can get to film other angles or some closer shots that I have not been really doing so far, or maybe from the same thing that I'm doing, film from two different angles. Okay, let me quickly change some things around and let's make some art. Before we started our renovation project and I had to put away all my art supplies, I was doing the Junk Journal July challenge, and I made everything up to day 14, and yeah, then I wasn't able to do anymore or didn't do anymore. So, but I do want to keep going because I find this quite relaxing and fun to have a prompt and go with that. So my next prompt is from day 15, tucked away, and I already started a page, but like, here it is. Oh yeah, I did. I put a marker in to find it easily and I forgot about it. So yeah, that's my page tucked away. So I already created a little pocket and I want to decorate this page and I want to create a little funny figure that I can tuck into this space. Here's what I came up with regarding the prompt tucked away. I put collage on my page, I put acrylic and gesso on my page, I used my new neon orange, which I really love. I looked for a quote and I really liked this one: art can be tucked away in all sorts of little places, by person called Tessa Sims. And yeah, here's my little guy tucked away, a little funny person tucked away in this pocket. Thank you so much for watching my vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. As I already said, like it if you did, subscribe to my channel, ask me questions. See you hopefully in the next one. Bye. And much love.